Back with another YouTube video. We're talking about some of the comments that have been received in the comment section below. I specifically want to address a question from, I think it's Herber Rodriguez. You asked us about the comparisons between some of the G30s and G35s on a 1J and what would be the right setup for that vehicle or that engine. Now, what I wanted to do is just go into a little bit more detail about turbo choice and a couple of other things that extend beyond just the turbocharger itself and the engine, the state of the engine being compression, cams, float head, etc., etc., a fully built motor as opposed to a stock motor, stock being standard volumetric efficiency versus a modified internal. Let's say you stroke the engine, you've changed the brake mean effective pressure, the BMEP of the engine, in other words, the volumetric efficiency of that engine, etc. What a lot of people don't actually take into account when doing a turbo matching process is they don't take into account the drivetrain. They don't take into account the transmission or the gearbox. They don't take into account the final drive, which has a direct effect on how responsive the engine's going to be in terms of how it can rev or how slow it's going to be able to go through the RPM band, which has a direct effect, again, once again, onto the actual turbocharger, AR size of turbine housing, actual size in terms of flow rate of the turbo for that specific application. So what I want to do is just answer your specific question. I think it tails off of a response that I made inside of this the comment section on this specific review, and where we compared the G30, the G25, the G20, the GTX35, etc. There's a couple of turbos that we did a comparison on. I'll put the description below in the link to that specific video in the description below. Now, someone asked me, please, can you compare these turbos on a four-cylinder engine? I responded and said, sorry, not going to happen anytime soon because we're currently building a 1J and it's going into a E36 shape, what we call in South Africa, a dolphin shape BM, etc., etc. And we're going to basically build a 700, 800 horsepower type setup, and we're going to use a range of different turbos to show you guys the differences between a G30, a G35, a GTX30, a GTX35, the BorgWarner Airworks range, a G30 with a 61 housing, 83 housing, 101 housing, etc., etc. So we'll probably do about 7 or 8 videos with different turbos and different AR turbine housings installed onto them, mounted to our 1J in this BMW. Now, that's obviously sparked another comment from Mr. Rodriguez, who asked, can you give me an idea which of the turbochargers would be best suited to a 1J? The G30-900, G35-900, or G35-1050? Now, I have these three turbos here in front of us, starting the biggest on the left-hand side or your right-hand side of your screen. In the middle is the G35-1050, G35-900, and G30-900. Now, which is going to be best for the 1J? It all depends on what transmission you run. Now, if you're running a very tall final drive, the engine is not going to be able to rev up through the rev range very fast. Yes, I'm using a 2-speed power glide with enormous power potential, firstly, but also at the same time, a hugely long ratio of gears. I mean, you change out a first gear at approximately 200 k's an hour, and this will see you through depending on your final drive, you're probably looking at around about 360, 380 k's an hour. And this came out of our drag car, which holds the South African record. We're the only car, door, turbocharged drag car in the sixes, but be that as it may. So what I basically want to go over is, yes, a G30 will spool faster than a G35. G30-900, G35-900. Why are they both 900? Well, if you have a look at the turbine side, the only difference between these two turbos, and once again, once I'm finished talking, I'll actually send, you'll see some close-up pictures of all of these turbochargers. You'll get an idea of the different sizes of the turbines, etc., that's coming just now. But just quickly, verbally, the G30-900 runs exactly the same compressor housing, bearing cartridge, compressor wheel, heat shield, fittings, etc., as the G35 does. The only difference, there's one difference, guys, the turbine wheel. That's it. The rest of the turbocharger is identical. From the AR turbine housings, absolutely everything is 100% the same. Same castings, same everything. The only difference is G30 turbine wheel, G35 turbine wheel. That's why it's a G35-900 and G30-900. Now, out of these two turbochargers, let's say, for example, you're building a street car. It's something you want to climb into, you start, drive to work and back, you want to go to the shops and back, you want to go to a meet, you want to go to a breakfast run, you want to go to the drag strip, a general all-purpose car. You don't have the budget to go and build a drag-specific car and a circuit-specific car and a street car, whatever the case is. You want the best of all worlds, realistically, in one car. Which turbocharger would I choose? The G30. Even with a 1J. Because it's a 900 horsepower capable turbo, it tells you it's got a high flow compressor wheel on the other end, and so does the 35. But the 30 is going to obviously respond a lot faster than what the 35 will. So smaller turbine, same AR turbine housing. However, the turbine wheel, lighter, smaller, faster to respond, and perfect for a street car application. You can run it at whatever boost pressure you want, and you'll still be able to achieve high horsepower output. If you're gonna run a top end car, for example, or more of a drag car where you want to spend, or a circuit car where you want to spend more time in a higher RPM band, go for the 35. There's less back pressure in the turbine. It'll obviously make a little bit more power, boost for boost, pound for pound, than the 30. Yes, they've got the same compressor stage. However, pound for pound, you'll probably see more power coming out of the 35 purely because of the fact that there's less back pressure in the turbine stage. And you'll still be able to achieve 900 out of both of these turbochargers, but you will see a different linear response curve coming out of the 35. If you're running a top-end car, 35 without a doubt. Now that's assuming we're using the same transmission. Now what I'm busy building as an example, and you guys can obviously just take this as part of the learning curve here, is we're using a 5-speed Getref box, which comes out of the M3, the 5-speed M3. It's the old E36 M3, the 3-liter model, which came out of the Dual Vanos. You've got a 5-speed box. That's the gearbox we're running. And we're running the 325 TDS, the turbo diesel differential at the back, which has got quite long legs. But we're going to be obviously using a G30 on that specific car. When we're finished with everything, we're going to land up running the BorgWarner. For various reasons, I tend to lean more toward the BorgWarner than the Garretts on this specific build, and combination of transmission and final drive. But that's just a little bit of info for you. Assuming you're using the same drivetrain, same final drive, same gearbox, and you want a street car, G30 for response. Top end and circuit car, spending all of your time in the high RPM range, G35. Then you get the G35-1050. This is the guy that's got the biggest compressor wheel, and obviously flows 150 horsepower more than what the G35 900 will flow. Once again, the only difference between these two turbochargers is the compressor wheel and the AR of the compressor housing. The bearing housing is the same, the cartridge is the same, the heat shield is the same, the fittings are the same, the turbine blade is the same. The only difference is the high flow compressor on the 1050 as compared to the 900, and obviously because it's a higher flowing compressor, you've reached the stage where the 1050 compressor will outflow the AR, the volume inside of the volute, of the AR70 compressor housing of the G35-900, and it requires an AR72. So it's got a larger compressor housing to cater or to allow to handle the additional flow that the larger compressor wheel will basically provide. So that's the difference between these two. The difference between the G30-900 and the G35-900 is purely just the turbine shaft alone. The rest is identical. So I hope that's helped you guys. I hope that's answered your question. If there are any other questions, post them down below. Interact with us and we'll help you wherever we can. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, and let us know what you think. See you next time.